Data is the new oil. It is the basis for many recent developments, such as increasingly intelligent smartphones, improved processes in industry, computers that win games such as Go and chess, and scientific discoveries in biology and many other sciences. However, just like oil, data is not useful by itself. It needs to be processed in order to become useful. And processing data is not easy. Let me use an example to illustrate this. Suppose that a hospital has collected data regarding the levels of expression of genes in a number of patients. Then a fundamental problem on such data is whether we can find relationships between the expressions of genes and diseases that are present in the patients, such as breast cancer. Unfortunately, finding such relationships is not easy. An important problem is that for some diseases, it is relevant not only to consider relationships involving individual genes, but we also need to consider combinations of genes. Even if our data set only contains data involving 300 genes, the total number of combinations can be more than 10 to the power of 90. This is more than the number of atoms in the universe. This illustrates the problems that I am studying in my research. How can we develop algorithms that find patterns and models and correlations and associations in large data? Algorithms that solve this problem in a generic manner are known as data mining and machine learning algorithms. They can be applied on many different types of data, including but not limited to biological data. The problem of finding combinations of genes is a good example. It is a problem that is known in its more generic sense as the problem of item set mining. In this case, we treat highly expressed genes as generic items. How do my algorithms work? They often take a similar approach. They build a search tree. The leaves of this search tree correspond to the different possible item sets. The internal nodes reflect decisions whether or not to include items in the item sets. This tree can become very large. The trick to make this algorithm efficient is that we use constraints to remove parts of the search tree. A reasonable constraint in our example is that we are not interested in combinations of items that are not present in our data. We can use this constraint to remove those parts of the search tree that only involve those combinations that we are forbidding. Using this trick and many other such tricks, I developed an algorithm that can find item sets in data with thousands of items. I believe that this approach can be used to solve many other problems as well. Consider the problem of explainable artificial intelligence. If a computer is used to suggest treatments for patients, doctors would like to be able to understand these predictions. Consider the problem of fair artificial intelligence. If a computer is used to make decisions that involve humans, these decisions should be fair. For instance, the computer should not discriminate. Fairness can be seen as a constraint on the outcome of a data mining algorithm. Hence, the use of search and constraints is a generic approach. If you have data and you think that search could be useful to identify patterns in this data, then don't hesitate to contact us.